Okay, let's talk a little bit about parenteral nutrition. So, enteral feeding and parenteral nutrition, both of them. So, if it's parenteral nutrition, it is through the IV. So, patients that receive normal saline with dextrose, that sugar is just a very, very tiny amount of sugar. So, in some ways, they're getting a little bit of nutrition. So enteral feeding, though, we have a nasogastric tube. We could have a gastrostomy tube or a jejunostomy tube. Why would you place one further down? Well, it all depends what's going on with the patient. Sometimes if you put things down in the jejunum, it's further down. If they have gastric problems, then that's where you want it to be. If they don't have stomach problems, then a gastrostomy might be better, or a nasogastric tube. Other than the nasogastric tube, the other two are placed down in specials. Usually when a patient has any kind of feeding tube, there is one of these Lopez valves on it. You've probably seen that in clinical, where you open up one, you can put stuff in, you have to reclamp it. So that helps opening and closing the system when you're putting in meds or you're putting down feeding tube. Here's an example of a gastrostomy tube. This person does not have the Lopez valve on there, but that's what basically it looks like. You could put the valve on right there. Here's another one. It's a larger one. They've got a giant clamp on the tube. That's a pretty big clamp right there. So enteral feedings. So different kinds of enteral feedings, depending what's going on. It could be intermittent, meaning 3, 4, 5, 6 times a day, you just give a feeding of so many mLs and it drips in. So intermittent is just equal feedings throughout the day. That's more common. That's like we eat normally, not everything all at once for the day, so intermittent. Continuous is basically anywhere from 18 to 24 hours at a time. Lots of the continuous enteral feedings go on 24/7. I mean, they just keep running. Very slow amount, it drips in very slightly. Bolus would be like 3 or 4 hours, and you just do with a big syringe instead of using a pump. Like intermittent, it would be a bolus. So you just bolus in 250 every 3 hours. So it all depends what the patient needs, depends what the doctor's orders, depends what the issues are with the patient. There's a lot of variables depending on what's going on and what's going to be the best treatment for the patient. So tube feeding administration, basically there's going to be an order. Doctor writes an order for nutrition to come do an evaluation, decide what kind of nutrition the patient needs, how many calories. There's lots of different packaged enteral feedings, some for the kidneys, some for the liver, high calories, low fiber, so it could be all kinds, different kinds you see. Common one is Jevity. That's a very common one you see. So if a patient has feeding going and it's continuous, every 6 hours usually, the nurse has to check residual. So they stop the feeding, they use one of those giant 60 ml syringes, and they check the residual. They just keep pulling back out of the feeding tube to see how much is there. Patient needs to be, head needs to be elevated when you do that usually. Also needs to be elevated while they're getting the feeding tube, especially if it's a NG tube. So they just check that. Now per policy, depending on how much they pull back, they're going to put back in the patient. So I think St. Luke's, for example, is up to 200. It's going to be more than 200 that you pull out, I believe, until you put back in, or that you leave it out. So if you pulled out 120, it all goes back in the patient. So that feeding, most all feeding liquid smells nasty. So imagine you're pulling that stuff out and having to put back in. So it's got medications, it's got It's got hydrochloric acid. It's got the feeding tube. So basically, they have to check that. If it's too much, they may have to stop it, slow it down, things like that. So total parenteral nutrition, though, now that's what we're talking about in the enteral nutrition, parenteral nutrition. These are patients that can't have anything by gut. They're MPO, they've had certain surgeries, so they need nutrition. They may have total parenteral nutrition. So total parenteral nutrition basically is all going in the IV. You've probably have seen these are giant bags. They usually run for 24 hours. They have a whole list of, you know, minerals, electrolyte, insulin can be in it, sugars. So it gives them pretty much everything they need. And that goes in the vein. It runs slowly, 24 hours. Sometimes the doctor will also write for lipids. So you would get a bottle of, it looks like a bottle of milk that goes in as well. And so patients now getting lipids, fat, and also other things. So that has to be run. Total parenteral nutrition has to be run in a central line. So a PICC line, a subclavian line, anything like that. There are out there a form of parenteral nutrition, not total, that basically they can give in a central or in a peripheral IV. The common one you see is Clinimix, C-L-I-N-I-M-I-X. Clinimix basically is clear, but when you get that, it comes separated. You have to break a seal and you mix it together. So that does not have to be given in a central line, but that also is not called total parenteral nutrition. TPN, the big bag, goes in a central line. Peripheral nutrition, like Clinimix, can go in a regular IV. So what do we know about TPN? Well, TPN, if it's being given 24/7, you have to hang new tubing every 24 hours. Wait a minute. So this slide, just to make sure, this is this slide has to do with enteral nutrition. Sorry about that. So enteral nutrition. They also need tubing every 24 hours. You're going to flush with water in the gastric tube, the duodenostomy. You can give medications down there. You can add extra things to the feeding tube. Lots of times a patient will not receive enough fluid, so the doctor will order just 3 or 4 times a day, give tap water down the NG tube, down the gastrostomy tube, down the duodenostomy tube, so anything they might have extra water as well. Complications of a patient on feeding tube, so enteral feeding, well, it can cause, they could aspirate if they're elderly or any other way. Because of the high calories, some patients have diarrhea. Too high of calories may cause constipation, maybe hyperglycemic. People that are on enteral nutrition have to have their BGs taken regularly because they're high in calories. If you don't give them enough fluid, enough water, they become dehydrated. So these are all complications of enteral nutrition. So usually the bags of enteral nutrition, it comes up in a can, you just pour the can in, or you may have a special mix of one that's actually refrigerated, and then you're going to discard what's refrigerated after 24 hours. So it is set on enteral feedings. It's also set on parenteral feedings. If you have to shut it off for any reason, you do not play catch up. If you're pouring in a certain amount from a bag that's open, like a carton, it's like a carton of milk in the refrigerator, you only put in 4 to 8 hours at a time. You don't fill that bag up. Since you're changing the bag and tubing every 24 hours, if you're doing the bolus feedings or you're doing the intermittent feedings, you just basically rinse out the bag and then it hangs at the IV pole and you change it every 24 hours. You can't mix old formula with new formula. So a person who's not eating or drinking orally, they're going to need oral care. So they need to have their mouth swabbed. That's an issue. Skin care, if they have a nasogastric tube, they're going to have breakdown around their nose. You got to watch the skin care and make sure the site in the stomach is also clean. Changing that is not a sterile procedure. So there's lots of things going on. Checking whether the patient tolerates it, lab values, how's everything working. So always when you're going to put a new bag on, whether you're doing enteral or you're doing TPN, you got to check the bag against the order. You don't allow the bags, anything, to hang more than 24 hours. Change the tubing. You don't play catch up. If you have to shut them off for any reason, go to specials, go to a procedure. Everything gets changed. On TPN, you're going to have a filter. So you need to change that tubing and filter every 24 hours. So assess the insertion site on a central line as well. Vital signs, daily weights, INOs, all these things are going to be looked at with a central line or a gastrostomy tube. So key points, TPN has to be on an infusion pump. You're going to be doing blood glucose at the bedside for TPN as well as usually enteral. If you run out and you don't have a new bag of TPN, then hang D10 waiting for the next bag because they're very high in calories. You don't want the patient to go into hypoglycemia. You can't give anything through the TPN, any meds, can't give blood products. Although, check your policy because there are some medications like some antibiotics that can be given through TPN. So just check your hospital policy, see what's going on.